Hey guys, welcome back to the DimCad channel. It's November 4th, 2016. I'm Reginald, also known as DimCad. Looks like that forest fire out there near Jenkins, Kentucky is gonna be a little bit more under control. There's a lot of high winds recently, but last night we had really good rain, so wish them luck. The National Guard's definitely been working on that. Jobs. A report came out stated that the U.S. economy created 160,000 jobs in the last month or so, and there's another report that Taco Bell is going to be creating another 100,000 jobs over the next 5 years or so, 5 or 6 years or so. By 2022, they're going to actually create about 100,000 jobs. I don't know if that's really useful, I mean, to be honest with you, because if a job isn't paying you enough to actually survive, if you can't pay your bills, then I don't know if that's really going to help you. I mean, I run into a lot of people who are struggling because they're forced to drive 40, 50, 60 minutes away from their home to jobs that don't really pay very well. Really, really low-paying jobs. And, of course, by the time you pay for gas, you don't have the money to really support yourself. And that's becoming a really big problem. And the only way to get the better jobs, the jobs that pay enough that for you to actually take care of yourself, you actually have to have a certain type of connection. I mean, that's the way it works now. You got to have that connection or else it's like, keep walking. it's sad. It's sad that you have to have a special connection to have a job that pays a living wage in this country. But that's what we're moving towards. That's where we're at right now in this country. We have 94.6 million people not in the workforce. That includes the very young and the very old, or the people who have retired, the people who are unable to work, and a lot of people who are unable to find jobs, and a lot of people who don't even want the jobs, don't even want to work. We have all these government benefits in place that sort of create a incentive for people not to work. It's easier for a lot of people to just leave the workforce and stay out of the workforce when they can claim these checks, and they realize the jobs that they're going to get don't pay enough to really justify them giving up these government checks. So that's another phenomenon as well. All right, pharmaceuticals. I was at work one time and I went to pick up some meds or drop some meds off or whatever. And this pharmacist was actually talking about this rise in EpiPens, the rise in the price of EpiPens. EpiPens, of course, are a system of delivering medicine. If somebody's allergic to something, they get stung by a bee and they're just extremely allergic to it and their throat starts to close up, they can use these EpiPens. Save their lives, deliver the medicine to their body, to their bloodstream pretty quickly and save their lives. They can actually save lives that way. It happens. Well, EpiPen, their price has soared. I was talking to this pharmacist and he was talking about how the price rose to a dramatic level. I read this article talking about how it rose by 3,900%. Crazy. Absolutely crazy. 3,900% is about $2,200 per vial. I went to get this medicine for this one person, and the insurance company did pay for it. It was Medicaid, and I think it was like $600-something for the medicine. And there's only like three EpiPens in there. There's only like three pens in there for like $600. And the pharmacist was talking about how, you know, he likes capitalism, but he was concerned that capitalism wasn't a good mix with medicine or pharmaceuticals. And I think it's not really just capitalism. I think it's a mixture of capitalism and socialism. I think when you have the government willing to step in through Medicaid and pay these extreme prices, it's going to create an incentive for, well, the pharmaceuticals to create extreme prices. If they know that, hey, these government programs are going to step in, they're going to pay these crazy prices, then they're going to have the incentive to create crazy prices. Same thing with tuition, college tuition. Yeah, it's great that people have access to the government loans and they're able to get these grants and go to college, but once that happens, it's easier money for the colleges, and therefore it's easier for them to justify increasing the tuition because they know that, hey, there's all this government money out there. So you go from a situation where it's like, oh, great, thanks to this government money, I can go to college, to a situation where, oh my God, because of this government money, I'm going to need the loans because I can't afford it. So that's a big part of it as well. Oh, WikiLeaks. Wow. So now they're releasing emails showing that the Clinton crew was talking about how a lot of ISIS was funded by the government of Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia again, huh? Huh, interesting. It came right. They said it came from the Saudi Arabian government. This is part of the Clinton email story. So the Clinton, the Clinton people were talking about how the government of Saudi Arabia, not just a rogue element of Saudi Arabia, but the government was actually funding them. And the crazy thing is that thanks to the Clinton Foundation, they were actually getting money from the same government. And this is what Julian Assange was talking about on RT. And it's just, what a crazy world. I mean, it's they're just doing it right in front of our faces. Like, they have no shame. Like, oh, well, yeah, I'm going to collect the money from the same sources that same people are giving ISIS money. I mean, it's just crazy. And people are like, oh, nope, not a big deal. You know, our supporters are like, no, this email story is not a big deal. I mean, people are people even looking at what's going on with these WikiLeaks? It's shocking. Absolutely shocking to some of us. To some of others, not really. Speaking of the election, looks like Donald Trump is moving New Hampshire towards his... New Hampshire is moving towards Donald Trump, and some other key states are moving towards Donald Trump. Guys, don't be surprised if Donald Trump wins Michigan. Do not be surprised, because with less black voter turnout, with less black participation, you're basically looking at Michigan with a less turnout from places like Detroit and Flint. And without those black cities, states like Michigan, they're not as blue as you think they are. They're actually pretty red without these big black cities contributing a lot of black voters with strong margins for the Democratic Party. Then you have Pennsylvania. Again, I think he can win Pennsylvania. I think he will win Pennsylvania. He'll probably lose Virginia. I definitely think he's going to win North Carolina. I mean, come on. I don't see how he loses North Carolina, a state that Mitt Romney won. Okay. I think he's going to do better than Mitt Romney did in North Carolina. I mean, I haven't been there. I'm just guessing here. You have less black turnout in early voting in North Carolina, a state that relies a lot on, a state in which a large percentage of their voters are early voters. I think it went from like 26 or 27% of the early voters being black to just 22% or so of the early voters being black this time compared to 2012. So I'm looking at that situation. I don't see how Hillary wins North Carolina. And then there's Virginia, which often, you know, I'm going to be blunt. Remember last time they had like a gubernatorial race? Everybody was shocked to find out how close that race was. The Republican was supposed to be way, way down. But then on election day, it was very, very close. And the Republican Party definitely, I think they regretted not spending any money and trying to support their candidate in that situation. I think it's just the last election cycle. Was that 2014 or something, 2012 or something? So I wouldn't be surprised if there's a swing towards Donald Trump and even in Virginia. I think Hillary Clinton needs to focus on Pennsylvania, North Carolina, Virginia, Florida. Those are some places she needs to really focus on. I mean, she's crazy. She thinks she's going to win Arizona. Again, I'm just guessing. What the hell is she doing in Arizona? But anyway, all right, guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Do you still think Hillary Clinton's going to win this thing? It's interesting. The WikiLeaks people are saying that basically the establishment won't allow Donald Trump to win. And I could definitely see that, because there's a lot of money on a line for a lot of people in the establishment to keep things the way they are. Because if Donald Trump gets in there, you know, they're not going to have their puppet, their corporate puppet anymore. So who knows? He might actually blow up everything, but in a good way. You know, I don't think there's anything wrong with somebody coming in there and making some big changes, because, you know, that might actually benefit the people.